It's my great pleasure to welcome you in Vilnius at the Baltic Military Conference 2019. And of course, my special thanks to my colleague and friend, Minister of Defense of Finland, Minister, for joining us. And of course, we will, after that, we will continue our bilateral agenda, but really your participation in this conference is really important. And let me say that Finland for us and its heroic resistance against the Soviet Union at this time was really and continued to be inspiring for all Lithuanian society, and it was in the past, but it's continuing now, and it was real inspiration for Lithuanian fight against the Soviets in the darkest times in the Soviet Union. And even now the cadets of military academy, they are studying the tactics and methods of war for Finland in the military war against the superior opponent. And as I said, I'm very much looking for the your presentation today, but as well as bilateral discussions which we'll have later. On the subject, learning to defend, adopting Western experiences in the Baltics is really a title of our conference this year. And indeed, when our military do not fight, and we expect that they will never fight, at least in the region, they learn and train. And the story of the Lithuanian armed forces after the restoration of independence in 1990 is very much the story of learning from the West, which means learning from the best. Very soon after regaining independence, Lithuania has declared her determination to become part of Western democratic nations, including membership in the NATO alliance. And well, this was after that it was the application for the membership in the NATO. This year we are celebrating 70 years of the alliance, which aim is to seek is to protect Western democracies as well as our freedoms and values, which we cherish. Since our accession to NATO, we have never looked back, and we have never regretted this choice. Even those who may have had doubts about NATO membership in the past, nowadays they are facing with the new aggressive Russia, and all we fully understand the importance of collective security guarantees. Today we all can witness the power of NATO solidarity. Over 20 allies have their troops deployed to the Baltic region as the deterrence measure. At the same time, NATO is undergoing profound changes to adapt for the new security situation caused by the Russian annexation of Crimea and aggression against Ukraine. I am sure that these issues will be thoroughly discussed during this conference. This month, together with our Baltic neighbors, Lithuania will be celebrating 50-year anniversary of our membership in NATO. With such anniversaries always comes a moment to reflect on what has been accomplished so far, and even more importantly, to look ahead. Clearly, we have come a long way over those years, learning from and together with our allies and partners, Lithuania has succeeded in creating from scratch the armed forces, and we are really proud about our armed forces today. Our forces have been tested in some of the most demanding operational conditions in Afghanistan, Iraq, Mali, and many other places. They have earned respect of our allies and, of course, of our adversaries. As we continue to invest into the modern capabilities and personnel training, our forces are becoming more capable with every year. We should also give credit to our political authorities. Since the establishment of independence, Lithuania has had many different coalitions forming the national governments. As everywhere, our political parties have had very different views on many things in life. However, there has always been one topic where all political forces would raise above party levels and speak with a single voice, which is national defense and the importance of NATO membership. I can say with confidence today that this political consensus will continue regardless of who will form future governments. Having reached the 2% target of defense spending last year, all major Lithuanian political parties have signed an agreement on long-term financing of national defense and building continuous national defense capabilities. In this agreement, our leadership across the political spectrum committed to steady increase of defense spending towards 2.5% of the GDP by 2030. I also hear the same commitment to national defense from all leading candidates in the long presidential race. Therefore, I'm convinced that our armed forces will continue enjoying full support from the future commander-in-chief. However, the main reason for confidence about the future of the Lithuanian society is the Lithuanian society which stands united behind our armed forces. And the so-called resilience of the society is the key for the security and the preparation for defense if needed. We have full public support on many issues, be it the confidence in our armed forces, membership in NATO, or the presence of allied troops in the country. We also see an increased interest to be involved directly in the national defense efforts. After reviewing the conscription in 2015, the absolute majority of the conscripts have been volunteers. Almost one-third of them stay in the military after completing the conscription service, and they sign contracts as professional servicemen. This is really a very high figure. We also observe steady growth in the ranks of our national defense volunteer forces, as well as the patriotic organization Riflemen's Union, which is called the Lithuanian Shaumei. With this public support, I have no doubt that any aggressor would encounter fierce and well-organized resistance, not only from our military, but from the whole of the Lithuanian society. Last but not least, we also observe that Lithuanians fully share the pain of the Ukrainian brothers who are resisting Russia's aggression since 2014 and are paying a very high price for their democratic choice. So Ukraine is also fighting for us. Ukraine is keeping the southeastern flank of NATO, and we will keep supporting Ukrainian armed forces, and we will keep learning from the Ukrainians who have acquired unique experience of fighting Russia and its mercenaries. I am very glad to see Ukrainian speakers and participants in the program, as well as, of course, other friends and partners. And let me also express my gratitude to Colonel Marinonis and his National Defense Foundation, the Lithuanian Armed Forces, and multiple supporters of the conference. And indeed, your enthusiasm and dedication made the conference growing size and importance was every year. With saying that, I really, once again, I would like to welcome you to Vilnius, to this conference, and wish you all challenging and productive discussions.